I think it's like a huge part of Fall Out Boy is where we're from. It's what kind of separates us from a lot of the bands on the coast, kind of, I think, in general. Especially if you can put up with a Chicago winter, then you can deal with just about anything, kind of. So I think it's kind of like shaped our music and changed us a little bit. And more than even like, I guess, I mean, like, obviously in like the lyrics and stuff especially too, like, I mean, like, those are... would be completely different if we were from somewhere else. So
it's weird too, because sometimes you'll come back and there are like people who are excited to see you because they think, you know, you're something special or whatever, which I'm not. And then sometimes you'll bump into people who are like excited to see you because like they have no idea what you do. Like they just think you're some, like,
you're like, I'm in this band, and they're like, yeah, totally. Oh. But what do you really do?
Like all these guys have done pretty interestingly is they don't kind of flout their success and tell people, oh, we're really successful. You say we're in a band and we travel a lot.
You'll straight up know someone in high school, and like you come back from being minor league famous or whatever, and like they totally forget that and are just stoked on your band or whatever. Like I was at Dunkin' Donuts yesterday, and like I'm sitting there and these kids walk over for an autograph. I'm like, dude, I know you, man. That's insane.
Next Patrick week. Won't sign autographs. You hear that?
None.
For the most part, I don't really like leave my house except to go to the movie theaters or to eat food. We're gonna go to Homer's. That means you're gonna go right down Green Bay.
So this place we're going to eat, what's the deal with it?
It's this place called Homer's. We used to go there after soccer games all the time. It's pretty awesome.
Your mom said you were an awesome soccer player.
Yes, my mom's awesome.
Do your parents do the thing where they cut out stuff from a paper that like sounds like stuff?
Yeah, but it's like not stuff you're into at all. Like they're like, here's an article on John Mayer, and I'm like, eh.
Thanks.
Totally.
You're trying.
And then they like try harder, and they're like bands like Death Cab for Cutie. They're like your friends, right? I'm like, eh, I like them. I like eating comfort food, and you don't really get that as much on tour. Patrick hates barbecue sauce.
I hate barbecue sauce.
Random fact.
Little known fact about me, can't stand it.
Tonight, our friends in a band called The Academy Is are playing a show at the Metro, and they just asked if we would be into, you know, playing at all, and we decided we wanted to do something like just more intimate, so it's just going to be Patrick playing guitar and singing, and we're just going to play a couple songs and just talk about the songs with the crowd or whatever. I guess we're going to play some songs that we put in retirement and stuff, like songs off our first demo ever. And so I think if I were a kid and I was into Fall Out Boy, it's something that I think I would be excited.
Hopefully I won't be disappointed.
I'd say a good half of the amount of time that Fall Out Boy spends together is like either quoting 80s movies like Jay-Z lyrics or like referencing metal bands.
Maggots, Michael. Feeding maggots. How do they taste?
I think he's cooking garbage.
Collectively, the band's really more into like R&B and hip hop and stuff, and like metal. if the four of us meet up anywhere, it's like metal and hip hop.
I think of the band, I'm probably the one who listens to like the bands we play with the most, kind of. I like Starry, I like My Chemical Romance. I like a lot of bands we tour with.
There's some bands that really stand out to me, like that we tour with, like My Chemical Romance or like Motion City Soundtrack or Panic at the Disco. You know, some of those bands that like I just think are all Gym Class Heroes. I just think some of these bands are awesome, and like I'd listen to them anyway. You know what I mean?
I mean, last year was just the year of My Chem. You know what I'm saying? It was just like they came out with this thing that nobody else really done, I don't feel like, you know, and they just came out and they had their own twist on it.
I have your like original demo tape and everything.
Oh, awesome.
Like,
with the tape or the CD?
The tape.
No, you guys aren't playing with the Academy yet, are you?
No.
No.
Yeah. You guys used to everybody staring at each other?
Oh yeah.
And it's repeated in my
scene. I used to do gay porn, so I was very used to the stares.
Like people would be like, are you the guy from, and let me tell you, never approach somebody by being like, are you the guy from, because that person's always going to say no.
California, I got super pissed.
Ass. Whoa! Yeah! Whoa!
Wait, is our camera on or not?
They're really very faithful to their fans and really loyal to their fans. Actually, the whole band came over to my school, and we have a 14 grade school that starts with junior kindergarten and goes all the way to 12. And we have weekly assemblies. And they actually did a show there a year ago for all 14 grades, and it was pretty amazing. That was pretty cool. Then they took questions afterward, and the first question came from a kindergartner, and you can imagine it was pretty funny. Like, how do you hear? How do you hear the music? It was funny.
My parents, whenever we play Chicago shows, need to have like 20 people on the guest list.
My friends will tell their kids that they know me, and immediately they're heroes in their kids' eyes because they know me. I mean, it's sort of, once removed from Peter, but for that makes their fathers look better because they know me, or their mothers look, oh, you really know them? That's terrific. We didn't realize you were kind of cool.
That's it. Somebody ring the doorbell or no?
Yo, so this has been a f***ing. Yo, so this has been a fun-filled day. Thank you for hanging out with us today. We'll see you later at the show. Peace. Watch out for the dogs. The best part about being a Fall Out Boy is, honestly, your job is to hang out with your friends and just hang out with your best friends. And that's just really like pretty much the luckiest life you could ever have. Fall Boys is just a bunch of kids who are in the right place at the right time. This street over here is my secret parking for the Metro. That's why we can't turn around. It's anybody can park here at all, but you don't know about it, so you can't. And we're going to go try to sneak in over here on the side door of the Metro, so come with us. It'll be awesome.
Maybe.
This is definitely the part of the show where the secret might get out, I think. Though I've been told by a couple people that everybody knows or is expecting it anyway. This is the thing. Until we walk out on the stage, I think it's still always up in the air, you know? So hopefully it'll still be exciting for people. So we're now backstage at the Metro already, about to run into our dudes from the bands right now. These guys are in a band called The Hush Sound. You'll see them sometime soon. This is Chris and Greta. They're awesome.
What's up, dudes?
Yeah. These are our f***ing dudes, the scene we came from. They're going to film you guys tonight, too.
Cool.
This is the Academy is. It's going to be f***ing insane tonight, hopefully. So good. I only heard it like 2 months ago for 1 second, and it's like in my head. This is our set list for tonight.
This is the hit. We're here.
This is Nick Smeka. His band let us play shows right in the very beginning.
Are we good?
Are we going?
I don't know.
We're filming for a show on Fuse today, right over here, so... this song's gonna be for William and all the rest of the guys in the Academios.
He is a gentleman. They're so stoked.
They love it, awesome. Man.
I mean, for you guys, they're like f***ing freaking out.
For you, you mean?
No, for you guys. I'm serious.
Thank you.
Dude, like, you drop the name and kids are like f***ing. I mean, it's your show, but I'm saying.
Yeah,
like,
they're calling you, man. Thanks for doing it.
It's pretty cool. It was awesome. I don't know. I don't get to do that a lot. I got to try out my new guitar. I think it sounded pretty good. I don't know, the kids are awesome. Chicago's awesome. It's my home. It's where I'm from. Where the f*** is my rider? F*** this thing.
No. Okay, never mind. I'll do it again.
Yo, we just wanted to thank Fuse for coming by and hanging out with us all day. These are the reasons, pretty much what you saw on the screen, are the reasons we think Chicago's the coolest city in the U.S. and the world.